Everybody knows what a heart attack is, but the same condition that causes a heart attack, atherosclerosis, or hardening of the arteries, actually affects not just the coronary arteries, but the blood vessels throughout the body. It's very common for that process to affect the vessels of the legs. And if you have blockage in blood flow to the legs, you can get pain in the legs when you walk, kind of like a leg attack, you know, which would be analogous to a heart attack. In its end stages, patients get sores that don't heal in the feet, or what we call gangrene, as a result of blocked arteries to the foot. It's the same process as heart disease, just different blood vessels in the body. So the most common and earliest stage of symptomatic lower extremity vascular disease is what we call claudication. Typically, that's described as cramping of the muscles below the level of blockage. So if you have a blockage in the pelvic or hip area, a patient might have cramping in the thighs when they walk longer distances or walk upstairs. If you have blockage in the thigh or at the knee level, you'll get cramping of the calf, and that's called claudication. Typically, the cramping is associated with walking or walking briskly, walking up a hill or walking up flights of stairs, because that's when the muscle is being exercised. It's demanding more blood flow. The heart cannot pump the blood down there because of blockages. If you have nighttime cramping, often that's more related to other things, electrolyte abnormalities, very commonly dehydration. So nighttime cramping, not necessarily. The most important things are what we call risk factor modification: stopping smoking, making sure the cholesterol levels are controlled, blood sugar is controlled in diabetics, and blood pressure is controlled. After that, we have some medications that help to improve the distance a patient can walk before they get symptoms. And finally, if the symptoms are severe enough, we go to procedures. We can do minimally invasive procedures such as angioplasty and stent that don't require operations or incisions. And if necessary, we can also do bypass surgeries of the leg. Again, analogous to a bypass surgery of the heart, where we surgically run a bypass around the blocked blood vessel in the leg. Here at Ohio State, we really pride ourselves on our multidisciplinary approach to treatment of vascular disease. Vascular disease is a condition that requires the expertise of medical doctors, surgical doctors, and interventional doctors. And here, we can provide a one-stop shopping experience for patients with vascular disease to get all of the treatments they need from all of the involved specialties.